11 News reporter Kim Dacey is live at City Police Headquarters this morning with more details on the story. Good morning, Kim.
Well, good morning, Stan. Sources close to the investigation have identified the officer as Will Torbett, an 8-year veteran of the police department. 1:15 Sunday morning, city police officers were outside Club Select on Paca Street trying to control the late night crowd.
During the course of that effort, there was an altercation that took place very near the club, and some officers worked to intercede in that fight, at which time some gunshots were discharged.
When the scuffle was going on, that's when I started hearing the shots, and I saw pepper spraying. So I ran behind my car and I ducked down.
According to sources close to the investigation, some guys tried to attack Officer Will Torbett when he attempted to break up a fight. That's when Torbett pulled out a gun to fend them off. Those sources say a nearby police officer shot at Torbett, not realizing he was a fellow officer. City officials haven't commented on the circumstances of the crossfire, but confirmed the outcome of the shooting.
As a result of that, one of our officers, a 8-year veteran, 33-year-old male, was shot and killed.
Police say a second officer and 3 civilians were also shot, but their injuries are not life-threatening. But a 4th civilian was killed. Friends have identified him as 22-year-old Sean Gamble. They say he wasn't armed, and the whole ordeal was a big misunderstanding.
He's a good guy. I mean, he's supposed to get married in 2 months. He has a 2-year-old little boy, fiance, working man. Man, good guy. He's not even no criminal record, anything like that.
Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake is encouraging everyone to pray for all of the victims' families. Reporting live at police headquarters, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.